In this video, the shown PCB enclosure parts are all manufactured and partly sponsored by PCBWAY. Thanks to PCBWAY for producing and delivering excellent 3D prints and PCBs in high quality. Welcome to Microdexed. This video is a build guide for the new alternative PCB-based enclosure. This supplements the default enclosure that is manufactured as a resin print and is the suggested solution since it offers best protection for all electronic parts and components. So this is mainly thought as an alternative when you neither want to order the printed parts or print them yourself. Then this solution consists of simply two empty PCBs, some screws and extenders. You can order and receive both enclosure types directly from PCBWAY. This build consists of a top and a base plate, and both are screwed together with common M3 screws, nuts, and extensions. Almost all used screws are M3 size. The only exception are the four M2 screws that tie down the Microdexed PCB to the base plane. Start with the base plate. Place M2 screws into every of the four holes from top of the Microdexed PCB through the base plate and secure them from the bottom side with M2 lock nuts. Continue with the four outer M3 extensions. The extensions have a visible length of 1.5 centimeters. On both sides of the base plane, you will need a M3 lock nut. The upper one is just a spacer for getting the perfect height. It is suggested to screw one of the nuts onto each extension, and then securing them from the bottom. Just as in the previous step, on the top of the lid part, you later will need four M3 screws that go into the extensions. But first, attach the display to the front plate. Again, this is very similar to the last step. One lock nut is directly above and one is below the display. A small tip, do not fixate the lock nut above the display fully yet. Then guide the screws through the PCB of the display. Then put the second nut on the bottom and screw them both together tight. This makes it way easier to compensate if there are any tolerances in the parts. Continue with the two encoders. They should come with a matching lock ring. If your encoders come with any additional PCB with resistors on them, it is advised to remove the PCB from the encoders. For Microdexed to work, you will need just the bare encoders. Another option is to just remove the resistors and trim the PCB they have. But be careful. For the right encoder, this can create some force to the SD card and can damage it when not aligned or cut properly. Connect the encoders to the Microdexed PCB. Be careful to not reverse pin directions of any connector. The pins on the Microdexed side are labeled on top and also on the bottom side of the PCB. As a test, verify that the ground pin goes indeed to the corresponding pin. Check the display connector pins when putting both enclosure parts together. If everything looks correct, you can put in the final M3 screws on the top plane. Your Microdexed now should be ready for first testing. Power it on from the micro USB connector on the teensy. If something does not go to plan, there are various methods to locate problems. For example, you can test the Microdexed firmware on the teensy without any additional parts by just connecting it to the web browser remote via USB. Also, please check the website FAQ and help section. Let us know in Discord if you have comments or questions. Thank you for watching.